The most noticeable change to the Excel 2007 interface is the addition of the ribbon. The ribbon is designed to help you use Excel commands and options quicker and more efficiently. The ribbon is also integrated into the other products that comprise the Microsoft Office 2007 suite of software. You will find as you work within the various programs and applications of the Office 2007 suite of software that the ribbon is a wonderful tool. We've already talked about the ribbon being comprised of tabs. You have the Home tab, the Insert tab, the Page Layout tab, Formulas, Data, Review, View, and Add-ins tab. The most commonly used commands are found in the Home tab. And also note that within this tab, as well as in the other tabs that comprise the ribbon, there are groups of features and options, such as in the Home tab, you have the Clipboard group, the Font group, the Alignment group, the Number group, Styles, Cells, and Editing. Each of these groups hold different commands and options and features that are relevant to that group type, such as in the Font group, you have the ability to change the font face, the font size, as well as apply formatting with just a click of a button. Also note that in the lower right-hand corner, there is another little button in different groups. If you click that button, it opens up into a dialog box that allows you more information as well as commands that you can use for formatting or applying any of the features relevant to that group. Let's go ahead and apply some features using our ribbon. Notice that I have this spreadsheet opened, and within the spreadsheet I have the column headings here of name, season, and planting depth for this spreadsheet. If I highlight them, I can quickly apply a new font by coming up here to my font group, clicking the arrow next to the font face, and then choosing a new font. I'm going to go ahead and apply an Arial Narrow font. Notice that it is immediately applied as soon as you select it. Now another nice feature of Excel that's also part of the Home tab is the Styles group. These are predefined styles that have already been set up for you. Notice that when I click the button, it drops down into a menu that lists all the various styles that have been pre-set up for you to use in your spreadsheets. Also note that as I move my mouse around onto these various styles, that they're immediately reflected in your spreadsheet. Choose the style that you might want by selecting it, and it is applied then to your spreadsheet. If I want to bold print and italicize this, I can come back over here to my font group, click my bold, and then my italics. Also note that plant depth no longer fits within the column width. I can come up here to my alignment group and choose my wrap text option. When I select that, the text is immediately wrapped in column C so that it no longer extends past the column width. Another nice feature of the ribbon is that there are contextually sensitive tabs that appear based on what functionality you are implementing within your spreadsheet. I have a graphic here that I've inserted into my spreadsheet. If I click this graphic, notice that over here I now have picture tools and a format tab available for my picture tools. If I click the format tab, I now have access to working with different features, tools, and options that relate only to graphics and pictures that you might have inserted into your spreadsheet. This is a nice feature because it allows certain tabs that you don't use as often, such as graphics tabs and picture tabs, to only appear when you are using that feature. As soon as I click away from my graphic, notice that contextually sensitive tab is no longer available. You also might find, as you're working with the ribbon, that it takes up too much real estate as you're working on a spreadsheet. Well, you can minimize the ribbon to show just the tabs. To do that, come over here to your Quick Access Toolbar, click the Customize Quick Access Toolbar button, and then scroll down to the Minimize the Ribbon command. When you select that, the ribbon collapses into itself with only the tabs available. Then, whenever you need a command, you can select the tab that contains that command or option and cause the ribbon to expand down, select your command, and then as soon as you select it, the ribbon collapses back up. To cause the ribbon to reappear in full format, again, just go back up to your Customize Quick Access Toolbar button, select it, pull down to the Minimize the Ribbon command again. Notice that this is a toggle switch. It will toggle the ribbon on as well as toggle the ribbon back to minimized. A quick technique to toggle the ribbon between minimized and not minimized is also to just double-click on any of the tabs that are visible. So if I double-click on formulas here, now that my ribbon is minimized, it will cause it to expand down. And to minimize it again, if I just double-click on the tab, it will shrink back up to a minimized view. Take a minute and explore the Excel 2007 workspace. If you'd like to open the file that I have opened on my screen, you can do that by coming up here to your Office button and selecting that, pulling down to Open, and then within the Open dialog box, navigate to where you have saved your course directory. Mine is in Documents. It's right here, Excel 2007, and if you open up Excel 2007, you will see a listing of all the chapters that comprise this course. Go ahead and open up Chapter 1, and inside of Chapter 1, you will find the file Ribbon. This is what you see on my screen. Double-click it to open it up, and have some fun, explore your workspace, and we will continue on with the next movie.